YouTube, Derek Dimes, Ghostpix ATS, your nation's number one trending sports handicappers right here on the East Coast, guys. First of all, if you're new, welcome. Thanks for tuning in to Dime Time. My name is Derek. Make sure you click that subscribe button down below. Turn those notifications on. You're going to be notified every single time I give you any type of free content, which is normally every single day here. But win, lose, or draw, we're going to be very transparent on this page. Whether we win a lot or we lose a lot, I'm going to show my little beautiful face on this screen. Still need a haircut. This is like a Barry Bonds record for not getting my haircut. But when you're grinding, you know, sometimes you don't have time for haircuts. So, but yeah, we're going to get over, recap our day, and let you know exactly what we had on our card yesterday. So yesterday's free play was on Liberty. I pushed it out at 9.5. A lot of people were saying the line had changed. By the time the video loaded, it possibly may have changed. So I don't know if you got it at 9. I don't know if you got 8.5. If you got it at 9, you got a push. You got an 8.5. You got a loser. But I'm going to assume that most of you got it at 9. I pushed it at 9.5, so I'll take it at 9. And we'll take a push there on that one. Yeah, very nip and tuck game there. Very back and forth. They kind of stretched it out on there at the end. So yeah, we'll say it's a push, I guess. I don't know how else to take it there. But that was the only play of the day that was a push or a loser. All the rest were winners. So we had a nice, beautiful day on the premium side, plus 18 units, and we're going to work our way through it right now. Top tier selection play was also the bracket buster that Jack had on his card. Jack had a monster day. Shout out to Jack. He's 5-0 with those type of plays. 8-unit play for him there. He's 5-0 in those plays. As we had Houston minus the 6 as my top tier selection play of the day. We had 3 March Madness plays as we've been doing here for the first few rounds. Obviously, as time goes on, we start to narrow those down a little bit and really lock in and focus on where we can get value at. But we did have Houston on our card yesterday, minus the 6. It was a nice, easy winner there. That was a 6-unit selection play for me there. My second highest rated play of the day was Central Florida. Plus the 13.5 was my second highest rated play of the day. I really thought that was just too many points for them to cover, with UCF being a more slowdown team and one of the most efficient teams in the country. They were actually the most efficient team offensively, scoring the basketball in their conference. So I knew they could shoot and make shots, which is crucial against the Duke Blue Devils. If you're not making shots, they're just going to run you out of the gym with their transition offense. So them being able to score slows the game down even more and allows them to set their defense, which was a huge reason why I liked UCF, which I got a ton of emails about why I was taking UCF. But a nice winner there. Iowa comes back and covers for us late. Actually had a chance to win that game outright. We had them plus the 8 points. That was a 3-unit selection play, least confident play of the day, but still felt pretty solid enough to put it on the premium side. And then in the NBA, we had the Clippers 4-unit play going up against the Knicks. The Knicks are terrible playing anyone, especially a team like the Clippers, who are trying to make work themselves into playoff position here on the West Coast. Clippers minus the 10, a nice easy winner there. So four premium plays, 3 in March Madness, sweep there, and 1 in the NBA with a sweep. So 4-0 on the premium side, plus 18 units are on the day, guys. Very successful day. We're going to keep it rolling here. Last week was a great week. We're going to keep it rolling here on the Dime Time train and keep chugging along. But, yeah, that was kind of corny. But we're going to keep it live. But make sure you check out the other cappers. Everyone had a monster day yesterday. Benny goes 4-2 with double top-tier winners yesterday, plus 12 units overall on the day. Jimmy had a top-tier winner. Jack had the bracket buster winner, an 8-unit play. He's 5-0 in those plays, as I said earlier. Chase goes 7-2-1 yesterday with a plus 160 winner in NASCAR, top-tier selection play. If you're not on Chase's NASCAR, check it out. He's doing very, very well in that, making a ton of money. As far as I've been told, he's been showing me, he's been raking in some dough. So if you're interested in NASCAR, that's something you want to get down with, make sure you hit Chase up, as he's absolutely crushing NASCAR right now. Obviously, check out Benny, UFC King, crushing it as well. Jack, Jimmy, all great members of the Ghost Team. Down below, guys, the links. Go down there and make sure you follow those guys. We're creeping up on 1,800 subscribers ourselves. Help me get to 2,000, guys. We get to 2,000 and we'll have a wonderful giveaway. We'll give away some packages, maybe some t-shirts, maybe some hats. Something nice for you guys to let you know I love you. Because without you guys, there is no me. So thanks for everything that you guys do, following along, commenting along, all that good stuff. Drop a comment below. Let me know what you want to see in the videos or what you want to see from Ghost Picks. I saw someone said something about a parlay package. That's something that we are going to look into. I talked to Jimmy a little bit about it yesterday, but not too in-depth. So we're going to dig into that a little bit more for the future as far as parlay packages. I've had a number of customers asking me about that. So it's something that maybe we ought to look into. But yes, yesterday was a phenomenal day for everyone on the Ghost team. Moving forward, guys, we're going to get to the free play. I'm not going to waste a ton of your time trying to keep these videos under 7 minutes here. 6 o'clock on the East Coast. We're going to go over to the NBA. March Madness is on a little lull here, taking a little break before they fire up and get back at it again. I will possibly have some NIT or CBI games later on, but not a whole ton. Those games, I feel, are kind of sketchy because you have to wonder about teams' motivation playing in that game. Some teams are rebuilding. Some teams are just playing for the fun of it. And those gyms are empty, and I don't care what anyone says. Playing in gyms that are empty, they're hard to get up for, man, and they're hard to get motivated for, and they're hard to play for. It's like playing backyard with your friends, you know. It's not the same juice in the building. But, well, I'm sure we will have some plays in that as well today. I'm looking at a short card, possibly only 3 plays total. But we're going to go over to the NBA here with the 76ers going up against the Orlando Magic. 76ers here are such an annoying team, and I love my Philly teams, but they're favored here, -2.5, going up against the Orlando Magic, who are at home and have been having a beautiful streak here, a nice little run at home with Philly coming to town here. I am taking the 76ers on the money line, guys, and the reason being is I don't trust them with only 2.5 points, especially on the road. They're just coming off a bad loss against the Atlanta Hawks, where they had so many bad turnovers, so many lulls defensively. I look for them to re-engage in this one and lock in and get a nice win against the Orlando Magic. I do expect Orlando to fight. I think this is going to be a very close game, but I don't trust them to cover the spread either, so I'm taking the Sixers on the money line. Orlando, one of the best defensive teams in the league. They actually have the lowest points per game, opponent's points per game after the All-Star break here. I believe it's around 103, 104, around that range. But they've been playing very, very terrible teams here, some bottom feeders, as their win streak has included Cleveland, Atlanta, the Pelicans, Memphis, some of the bottom dwellers of the NBA. So they've got their run on that, but they're playing some of the top dogs here now, and the 76ers. On the East Coast, I expect them to bounce back as they want to maintain position here of that 3 seed in the East and keep it rolling. Also, Orlando may be looking ahead in this one as they have to face the Miami Heat, and that will pretty much be not a determining factor, but a huge determining factor as to who makes the playoffs in the 8th spot. So Miami and the Magic will be playing each other head-to-head on Tuesday, and this could be a little bit of an oversight game for the Magic. Not oversight, but I think that they really have to get up against the Magic. So if they lose this one, maybe they'll sit some guys and really juice up their energy to get ready for Miami, because that game carries more importance than the 76ers here. But I'm going with the Sixers here on the money line is the official free play of the day. -135 is the official free play. 76ers -135 juice money line, official free play of the day, guys. We're 7-3, I guess, in two our last 11 free plays. I counted this last one as a push. But jump on packages, guys. Jump on the team. As you can see, we're all red hot. I'm absolutely crushing it here. So make sure you jump on with GhostPicksATS, GhostPicksATS.com, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, at Derek Dimes is my handle. Make sure you follow us there, guys. Have a beautiful Monday. Let's start this week off right. Last week was great. Hope to have an even better one this week. Signing off, Derek Dimes, guys. 3 G's of Ghost is our motto here. Good luck, God bless, and grind on.